Okay, and also I see that not all of you can write here hello. Look, it's a hard task to write hello from the chat part. Okay, this is the web. Nina, welcome. This is the dashboard after we get our account from the our space, and from the hosting settings, hosting domain manager, from this part of the dashboard, hosting settings, okay, or hosting tools, from domain manager you will see this page, and from this one we are selecting create a free subdomain, and this will be your web address. I prepared here first nahityilmaz@webpages.com. Now I can prepare I'm not sure if there is, if it is possible. I will make it like this. You could see at web pages. If it is available, I will try. Okay, it was available. So this will be another web page of ours. Okay. When you click, it's going to open, but there is no file inside it, so it will not show anything. If I put...
Teacher, should we write our names down at the subdomain?
For the subdomain part, I want you to write something. Okay, better your names. It will be easier for me to understand. Okay, sometimes students are writing nonsense. Names to the web pages. Okay, as you can see, we have I have at least two web pages here. It looks like they're individual from each other. They are free from each other. We are going to make the settings, and how do we make it? From the content of this one, you can see delete or change it. And from the dashboard file manager, we are going to put some files in our document. Okay, also look, when you fill this one, when you fill this one, have you seen this from Schoology?
No.
It is... It is. This is 3B. Okay, in I made a mistake, sorry. 3B. From the HTML folder, website name. You have to click on this one. And because I made the test on mine, so I see this one, but you will see similar to this one with the drop down menu. You are going to select your class and your name and surname and web address name. Okay, similar to this one, you will just add HTTP to your website name. This will be...
What was the problem with my website name?
I will tell. There is no problem with your with the website name, but the file name, you made it philip.html, if you can see here.
Yeah.
Look now, when I click on this one, it will show the content. But look, if I type it like this.
Yes, I know.
Okay, so the first, at least one file name should be index.html, or previously there was a possibility to make it default.html. It works like that. Okay,
So I should change the name to index one.
No, index.html, index.html. It should be like this. index.html.
That should be the name of the file, right?
Yes, when it is like this, index.html, it will immediately appear like this. Now I'm going to show you with the other one that we create. Look, this is the file manager, and this file manager can reach also the other page. I can double click on this one, and I'm going to create a file. Okay, we are going to work like this, create file, and name of the file will be index.html, and I can copy paste some parts of this one. We are going to make it like this. Okay. Okay, and when you double click, you see the content of this one. We can delete some parts because there are too many information here. But we are going to make this one save. And now I'm going to type here. You could say. At web pages, what was it? At web pages, like this. Like this. And look, it shows this content. Previously, if there is no index file, it was not showing the content. Did you understand this part?
Yes.
Katya. Okay. Let's go back to the file part. This is, let's go back one more time.
Sir.
Yes.
I have a question that is not really related to this, but about Flash.
Yes.
What's the new name? Adobe Animate, because I couldn't find it to use this Google.
Adobe Animate, I think, yes. As I remember.
Yes, I download this.
Okay, this is the file manager to our account, and when you create a web page name, how do we create a web page name? I'm repeating one more time. From hosting, domain manager, from the create free subdomain part, we are creating, according to your name, you are creating a website name. Okay, and this is the subdomain, that's why it can use some others, but at web pages is easy for me, so I use that one. If your web page is related to other things like sports or game or other things, you can select. Later when you learn this one, maybe you can buy a hosting from the companies, any of these companies, and you can make your name, surname, like nahityilmaz.com. Okay, and it won't be any subdomain like that, but also when you buy it, you can create subdomains like class1.nahityilmaz.com, blah blah, similar to that one, because this is the domain name. This is the domain name, and we are using currently the subdomain part. So this is just a learning purpose, so we can use that names. And let's continue on this one. I will go to dashboard, file manager. The others, I said, if you use if you use or if you already prepared your website in your local computer, you can use FTP manager to transfer it, but also this file manager can be used for this file manager can be used for uploading files also. Look, there is an upload button. You can upload your files. Okay, now this is our file, and let me make it bigger. Here, this is the web page, and I add a code here. Okay, and it is the background color, and you can get this information also from W3 Schools that I gave you as a link. There are many things here in W3 Schools, and from the HTML part you can see others, but I will show you the basics so you can get information more detailed from this website. For example, I want to change the background color. We just add, because previously it was like that. Okay, the original was like that, but if you want to change the background of your web page, what we do, we are adding a style inside the body tag. This is the body. Okay, and before the close tag of the body, we put this one. For example, instead of this one, you can change this one dark blue, and some colors are coming with the name, because there are millions of colors. I will show you how to use that one also. And save it. Now when I refresh my web page, it's a dark, but previous one was better to see the content. Okay, I will go back and to get it back. This is easier. Or instead of that one, powder blue. You can use light blue.
I wanted to suggest it.
Okay. Okay. Now we can test it. Refresh. Now they are almost same, though. But powder blue and light blue are almost same. Okay. And let's put here a link. Okay. Then we are going to learn how to insert here a picture like this, putting a picture, and also changing the font color. Now we will put it here, and let's put here the hyperlink references, that links are written like this. You can remember it like this: a hyperlink reference. Okay, this is the link, and with equal sign, let's take something from this one. Let's close this one. Just a minute. I can type it here. Hyperlink reference. You can. I will try this one. www.google. And we can close this one. There's also a target part. I have to put it in double quotes. The target part is for opening the link in a new window or itself. We will see it. I will show it from the pages, but without this one, now I will just show this. And we are typing, for example, this one, Google, and we are closing the tag like this. When I save this file, save, and refresh this one, there's a Google link here, Google with blue underlined. It means it's a hyperlink. And when I click, there's a mistake because it is looking for this one. So let's go back. Let's type it like this, HTTP. Okay, you see the hyperlinks should start if it is calling an outside page, if it is not inside the files, if it is not the files that your web page contains, you can call it. Now we can create another page, like linked page we can create. Let's close this one. If it is out of your web address, you have to start with HTTP. If it is inside your website, you can just type the name of the page. Let's go back. Let's create another file here. For example, links.html. Instead of losing time with that one, I will just copy this part. Test it here, and let's write links with the H1. And of course, we have to close the body here. With the slash also, and also we have to close the HTML and the closing slash. Now I'm going to close this one with saving, and we are going to put the link of this one to our main file. Azer, welcome Azer. How many times? Okay. Let's go back and edit this file. And instead of this Google one, or we can type another one. A link reference equal to links.html. And we can close this one and close the tag. And we can type here internal links, okay, and close this one, and let's type here slash a. I'm going to show you one more thing about this one. Let's save this and go back here, refresh. Look now, one of them was Google, the other one was internal links. Let's add here a break. So the other one, break tag doesn't have any closing, it's not necessary because when the browser sees this code, it means it understands that the there is a break. It's not important how you style your file. You can put it here or you can make it like this. The important thing is how the browsers are compiling this one. They are compiling and they are showing us different. Save and refresh. You see.
What does that BR mean in the bracket?
Break. It's a break.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You can make it like this or you can put everything in one line. It's not important because the browsers like Chrome, Firefox, and other things, they are looking for the tags, HTML tags, HTML elements, and they are giving a result of this one. And when you click internal link, it's going to open this file because this is inner file. It's not an outside file of our browser. That's why we don't need to type here HTTP. Did you get this part? I think yes. Okay. And let's put here a picture. But before putting the picture, I have to import that picture. Okay. Let's take it and let's make, let's first import the picture here, upload the file. I will click and inside document, Einstein's picture, let's upload. Okay. And it is already done, so I can close this one. Einstein's picture is here. And let's put a picture to this one. And let's copy the okay. Let's close this one. And let's we have 10 minutes. Okay, I will go faster. Here, I will put it with a P because I assume that this is a paragraph and I'm going to paste. His quotes, I couldn't copy it. Imagination is important. Let's okay, and I will paste it here. It doesn't copy from that one. I will take it from the HTML code. Imagination is more important than. Let's put this part. To style fonts, I will show it, but I'm in a hurry to finish this part. Small screen. Okay. And put it here. And I can close this P here paragraph. And I can type here the Albert Einstein as the quotes owner. Also, let's put here with a break so we will see it under that one. Okay, and let's save this one. Okay, and let's refresh the main page. It's coming here and we are going to put a link to here and we will put his picture under this one. How do we put the picture? Now I will show you. The code for this one is image. Okay, it's written with Umagle. And the source of the file we need. So it is like this, with an equal sign. We are typing the file name. It was Einstein.jpg. And close this one, save it, and refresh the page. It comes here. But this is a very big picture here, and it affects. So we can go back here and put here with equal, for example, 100, and height equal 100. Save the file. And to refresh it again, it will be a smaller one. And if you want to put here, like I told you, to change these hyperlinks, for example, when we can make a link to this one, and we can let's send this picture to next line. How do we make it? You can just insert here another break. And his picture will be under that one. And for example, not for the whole name, actually we can make it. But if you want to give the hyperlink only to the Einstein part, you can make it like this. Let's copy. Let's put here A. Okay. It is important from which I will close this one. From which character we are using on, I will change the place of that one. The hyperlink reference is this one. This time I'm going to give hyperlink to an image, not to a file or not to a website. Einstein.jpg. And let's see it like this first, but also I have to put here the closing text of the A. This is the link. So there will be a link at the Albert Einstein name, whole name. I will save this, refresh my page. Look, there is a hyperlink now at his name. And when we click, it opens the picture at the set. Also, I said there is a part for the hyperlink references. It can be, we can type here, I forgot something here. Okay, at this one, first I'm going to change the hyperlinks place. I will cut it and paste it here. It's also possible that you can use this one. There should be a space. Now I will save. I will refresh my page. It was the whole name. Albert Einstein has that hyperlink. But this time, after refreshing, you see only the Einstein has the hyperlink, because this one shows. This one shows here, if it is from the name after the name and before the surname. So if you want to put a hyperlink to all characters, the hyperlink code must be before that part. I think you understood. Not sure if I could explain well. Okay, so it was this one, and I said there is a target part, target, and equal. It was like this. Self. This one. The default is self, actually. When you refresh, it's going to open it itself. And let's use blank. It's going to open in a new file. Refresh the page. When you click, it's going to open in a new tab. Look, the other one was here. When it was self, it was opening at this tab and showing us. And if it is, if you change the target, it's going to open in a new tab, the hyperlink part. So we don't have enough time. Let's just review this one. We can type this one, but also color codes. I will type here HTML color codes. Instead of typing the name of the web page, sorry, name of the color, you want to use this color, but we cannot say how green it is. We just say kind of a variety of green. So we can just copy the code of this one and go here. Change this one. I will check if there is a mistake. Okay. As you see, it changed the background color. I have less than 1 minute. Maybe it's going to cut immediately. So what I want from you is clearly, I want you to prepare the website name for everybody.
Teacher, I resend my...
Okay, I understood what's your web page name. It's not important, the file name, but I want you to fill that form exactly so I can understand which website is yours, so I can click and I can see if you have done it or not. Let's make it like that. And because the lesson will finish immediately, so I want everybody